welcome to the Master's Child Church. We are happy that you've joined us for this time of worship. On behalf of our pastor, Bishop Melvin Robinson Jr., and our First Lady, Cheryl Robinson, and our entire MCC family, we want to extend a very special welcome to all of our first-time viewers and all of our returning viewers. We are honored that you tuned in, and we know that you're going to have a blessed time. To all of our MCC family, welcome back. God has blessed us to worship together once again. Make sure you help spread the word that MCC is here. Please take a moment to share this post, share our link, and please hit the like button. It's going to be a great time in the Lord. And while you're at it, make sure you follow us on YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. We're family, and we want to stay connected. Now we're going to open up with our scripture and prayer. Then we'll go into the time of worship as we prepare our hearts to receive a life-changing word. Let's continue to worship together.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. The songwriter said, I don't know what you come to do, but I came to clap my hands. I came to kneel and pray. I came to praise the Lord. I don't know what you came to do, but I came to give God everything that I have this morning. Hallelujah. Oh, God, he is so wonderful on this morning. We're going to ask everyone that can stand to please stand for our scripture and our prayer. Our scripture is coming from Luke 18, 18 through 22. A certain ruler asked him, good teacher, what must I do to inherit eternal life? Why do you call me good? Jesus answered, no one is good except God. You know the commandments. You shall not commit adultery. You shall not murder. You shall not steal. You shall not give false testimony. Honor your father and mother. All these I have kept since I was a boy, he said. When Jesus heard this, he said to him, you still lack one thing. Sell everything you have and give to the poor, and you will have treasure in heaven. Then come, follow me. Father, in the name of Jesus, we come to you as humble as we know how, God. Oh, God, we come into your house to give you praise. We come to give you worship. We come to honor your name. We come to lift you up. We come to pray, hallelujah. We come to magnify your name, glory to God. Oh, God, there's no God like you today, God. A God that is a keeper. A God that is a healer. A God that is a deliverer. A God that is our burden barrier today, God. A God that is bridge over troubled water today, God. A God that is our father and our mother today, God. A God that is our all in all. And we thank you on this morning, God. Oh, God, we just ask right now in the name of Jesus that you will watch over those that are on their way, God. Give them traveling mercies right now, God. Send your shield of protection to them right now, God. Guide them to their destination, God, with no hurt, harm, or danger. And God, we want to thank you right now, God, for those who have assembled themselves, God, that you allowed us to reach our destination, to come into your house one more time, God, just to lift up your name, God. Oh, God, we ask right now in the name of Jesus that you would just saturate your spirit right here, God, because we can't do nothing without you, God, but we can do all things through Christ that strengthen us, God. We'll be torn down, God. Build us up right now in the name of Jesus. Oh, God, where are we lacking, God? Give us the strength to know what we need to do, God, in the name of Jesus, God. Oh, God, somebody needs a healing on this morning, God. They got a bad doctor report today, God, but we will remember the report of the Lord, God. We believe you today, God. You said that you was a healer, and we trust you right now, God. God, you said you was a deliverer, and we trust you now, God. God, you said you was our Savior, and we trust you today, God. Save, Lord, as never before, God. Let someone come up here, cry out, what must I do to be saved, God? If someone backslid, God, let them slide back into your presence, God, in the name of Jesus, God. Oh, God, hear our prayer this morning, God. We need you this morning, God, as never before, God, in the name of Jesus. Thank you for protecting us this morning, God. Oh, God, thank you as we slumber and slept, God. You watched over us all night long, God. You didn't let no thieves break in. You didn't let no fire break out. But we woke up this morning, God, with joy down on the inside. Oh, God, we lift you up, God, in the name of Jesus. Oh, God, we ask that you watch over our children today, God.
Watch them as they go to and fro, God, not even knowing what's going on, God. But we sit in prayer right now in the name of Jesus. Protect them, God, from all seen and unseen danger, God. Keep them as never before, God. Keep their mind today, God. Guard their heart today, God. Oh, God, give them wisdom, God, to know what's right and what's wrong, God. In the name of Jesus, God. Oh, God, move by your power. Move by your spirit, God. In the name of Jesus. Oh, God, those that come to sing the songs of Zion, anoint their voice right now, God. Let it be sweet smelling unto your nostrils, God. In the name of Jesus. Oh, God, remember the musicians, God. Touch their hands and their feet, God. Oh, God, in the name of Jesus. Oh, God, the one has come to break the bread of life, God, because we cannot live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeded out of the mouth of God. Send a fresh word on this morning, God. Let us leave out something different today, God. In the name of Jesus, we ask that you move by your power, move by your spirit, God. These and all our blessings we ask. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
That was a good prayer right there, I'm going to tell you. Ooh, good morning, MCC. Welcome to our Sunday morning worship experience. On behalf of our senior pastor, Bishop Melvin Robinson Jr., and executive pastor, First Lady Cheryl Robinson, we want to take a moment to welcome you to our sanctuary, both in person and in our cyber sanctuary. We also want to welcome our first-time visitors. Are there any first-time visitors? Welcome, welcome. We have a first-time visitor. Let's show us some love, y'all. Be sure to, if you are joining us from another area, please type where you're watching from in the chat. Be sure to like us on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and YouTube. If you're watching via YouTube, be sure to subscribe. At this time, please join me as we recite our Path to Greater mission statement taken from John 4:12. It will appear on the screen. Epitomize what Jesus did. Exceed what Jesus did. Enlighten those who will continue what Jesus did. Everything we do for the success of the Path to Greater initiative must be facilitated through who God is. God is love, and love never fails.
Amen. Can we clap our hands and give God glory this morning? Truly, He's worthy of our praise. Amen. We come to bless the Lord. Amen. Anybody made a commitment to the Lord that you're going to bless His name? Come what may, you're going to bless His name. Amen. Let's clap our hands and give Him glory just one more time. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Said, I will bless the Lord at all times, and His praises shall continually be in my mouth. No matter what I see or how I feel, as long as I'm breathing, oh yes, I'm breathing, I'll bless the Lord. Is that your prayer? As long as I'm breathing, oh yes, I'm breathing, I'll bless the Lord. Can we give a praise right here? Shout hallelujah. Come on, shout, you're worthy. Right here. Come on, say, I will bless.
I will bless the Lord at all times.
And His praises,
and His praise
shall continually be in my mouth.
In my mouth.
No matter what I see,
no what
or,
I
how,
see
I feel,
or how I feel.
As long as I'm breathing.
As long as I'm breathing.
Oh yes.
Oh, yes.
Let's do it together. said, if he's been good, can you give him glory? Come on, you ought to think about all the things that he's done for you. It should have been another way, but he's been good. Hallelujah. That's why we're gathered this morning, just to tell him thank you. He didn't have to do it, but we just want to tell him thank you for keeping us. Thank you for loving us in spite of us. God, we thank you. God, there are no words that really can express how we feel and how thankful we are, God. But the least that we can do is just wave our hands.
You've been so good. Oh, you've been so good, yeah.
That's why our testimony is so many doors you've opened, so many ways you've made, so many times you've healed me. You've been better than good to me. So many doors you've opened, so many ways you've made, so many times you've healed me. Better than good to me. So many doors you've opened, so many ways you've made, so many times you've healed me. You've been better than good to me. Say so.
So many doors you've opened, so many ways you've made, so many times you've healed me.
Better than good to me.
Better than good to me.
Say.
So many doors you opened, so many ways you made.
Come on, shout it out. So many doors.
So many doors.
Down so many. So many times he's healed my body. He's been good when I was at my lowest point. Oh, his hand of mercy lifted me, turned me around, placed my feet on solid ground. And that's enough to wave my hands and tell him thank you. That's enough to say, Lord, I love you. Cause you've been better, 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 better than good. Oh, you've been so good. God, you have been so good. Come on, help me say you've been so good.
So good.
Whoa.
So good.
So
good.
Let the whole church say,
you've been
so good.
So good.
Oh, you've been so good.
So good.
Let me hear the voices out here say, you've been so good. Come on, lift it up a little bit higher. Say, so hear just the voices. You've been saying so. Oh, so. Come on, wave your hands while you're singing and say so good. You've been so good. Everybody say you've been so good.
So good.
You've been
so good.
So good. Last time you have
been
so good.
So good.
To me, yeah.
To me.
Come on, give him glory. Come on, if he's been good, give him glory.
He has been so good. He has been so good. He has been so good. And we know it for ourselves. It's our testimony that he's been good all of our lives. And he's been good to us. Can we give him another praise for so many doors he's opened, so many ways he's made, so many times he's healed us. I'm going to say it again. So many times he's healed us. He has been better than good. Good is an understatement. He's been better than good. Who can wash my sins away better than good? Who can forgive me over and over again better than good? Brand new mercies I see better than good. When others will have thrown me away, he said, I still want you better than good. Hallelujah. He's been better than good. Hallelujah. And we give him praise. Hallelujah. We used to say it this way, God is a good God. And we reply by saying, yes, he is. Can we give him a yes, he is praise? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. When others were sleeping in the midnight hour, he was awake, comforting us and giving us the strength that we need. When we thought we couldn't make it, he let us know that we could make it. And we give him praise, amen, and honor. Can we give him praise again? Come on, we came to do just that. Praise him again. Hallelujah. Let everything that has to praise him again. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in our mouths, and we give him praise. Amen. This is the day the Lord has made, and we are rejoicing and we are glad in it. Amen. And we thank each of you for joining us here in the chapel and in the cyber sanctuary. I want to know, can we give God praise together in the cyber sanctuary, in the chapel? Amen. I'm going to challenge those in the cyber sanctuary. Give some hand waves. Amen. Amen. Along with us as we clap and we give God praise for everyone. We do honor the Spirit of the Lord that's in this place. I'm going to say it again. The Spirit of the Lord is in this place. Amen. And we honor our King and our Savior along. Amen. For all the things that he's done for us and for who he is. And we thank God for our senior pastor, Bishop Melvin Robinson Jr., and our First Lady and Executive Pastor Cheryl Robinson. We honor them and love them, and we are grateful for their leadership. And we thank God for our co-founder, Irma Robinson Fitzgerald. Co-founder, we love and honor you. in the name of the Lord, to all of our overseers and to all that are here today. We are grateful to have Pastor Joe Hayden, amen, and Lady Hayden in the house. MCC Bowie is here, amen. We love you and honor you in the name of the Lord, amen, amen. To everyone that's serving in ministry, everyone that's here, know that we love and honor you. Can we do this? And when we do this, we're doing this for everybody, including you. If you hear me and see me, we honor everyone. Can you clap for everybody? I said everybody, everybody working in ministry, everybody that's here, because you made it, your neighbor made it, and we give God praise and we celebrate you in Jesus' name. You may be seated. Amen. We are thankful for another opportunity we have, amen, to come together again. And I am convinced that something is going to happen today that's going to change our lives for the better. Oh my goodness, I'm going to say it again. I wanted to stick. I don't want to throw it in. No, I want to stick. I wanted to stick that I believe, I'm convinced that something today is going to happen that is going to be for the good of them that love him and who are called according to his purpose. Amen. Anybody have faith to believe that today is the day you've been praying for? Today is the day that you might just get that phone call that your child is saved, that your parent is saved, that your enemy is saved. Come on, somebody. Today just may be the day that that tumor can be removed in the name of Jesus. Anything can happen in the presence of the Lord. So can you praise him in advance for what is going to happen in the name of Jesus? Praise him for what can happen. What can stop our God from moving in a mighty way in our lives? Nothing. Amen. Today is the day. Tell your neighbor, today is the day. Amen. And we give him praise in Jesus' name. Amen. I believe it's today. Amen. According to your faith, may it be done unto you. Amen. At this time, amen, we're going to turn our attention to the screens for our announcements.
The Master's Child Church 2024 theme, Do What Works, 1 Corinthians 10:23 through 24. Our theme for the month of April, Where He Leads, We Will Follow, Luke 24:50. Congratulations to the newly formed Flag Ministry Divine Inspiration on an outstanding debut performance on Palm Sunday. If you're interested in joining this ministry, rehearsals will take place April 21st. Please see Sister Victoria Williams to sign up today.
Flag Ministry.
New members graduation.
New members graduation is today.
Sunday,
here at our MCC Indian Head location.
Indian Head location.
New members will be celebrated along with family and friends in the fellowship hall.
Your family and friends are invited to attend the celebration.
In the name of Jesus. How many know that folks are still coming to church, y'all? Folks are still joining, whether it be in the cyber sanctuary or in person. We celebrate our Bowie location, amen.
Mitchellville Road,
God is moving. God is doing great things. So we're happy about it.
8 a.m.
Amen.
With Joseph Hayden Jr., location pastor, and Lady Zakia Hayden. Bishop Melvin Robinson Jr. will be the guest speaker April 21st at 2 p.m. at the 11th Pastoral Anniversary Celebration for One Nation Outreach Ministries. Join our MCC Growth Group on Friday, May 3rd at 7 p.m. as our special guest, Dr. Daisha P. Hastings, presents on Overcoming Depression for Mental Health Awareness Month with tips on how to assist others as well as helping ourselves. This platform serves the community as well. Let's continue to grow together. You are cordially invited to attend the official ordination service of the Master's Child Church on the 9th day of June in the year of our Lord 2024 at 4 o'clock in the afternoon, located at the MCC Capitol Heights, 7711 Walker Mill Drive, Capitol Heights, Maryland 20743. And stay tuned for new and exciting events happening in June 2024, Man to Man Men's Health Month, and July 2024, It's Family Month. We want to welcome our newest graduates and now members of the Master's Child Church: Alita Barbie, Ronald Bell, Kenneth Brooks, Raquel Brooks, Darren Green, Karen Gordon, Nina Queen Irving, Armani Jackson, Jeffrey Jackson, Laverne Jackson, Naisha Lane Sherman, Pam McKnight, Siobhan Nash, Verdell Nash, Aisha Nelson, Angela Denise Norris, Thomas B. Norris Sr., Claude Oliver, Michelle Oliver, Michelle T. Perrin, Robert E. Perrin Sr., Catherine Pickens, Latoya Roberts, Michelle C. Shorter Merritt. Congratulations! We thank God for adding each of you to the MCC family. We look forward to what God does next in your life. MCC, let's congratulate our graduates. Welcome to the Master's Child Church. One church, three locations.
I'll tell you one thing. I'm happy, and I know we're all happy together to see what the Lord is doing within MCC. Amen. We do have a celebration afterwards for our new members. But new members, if you could lift your hand where you are, you don't have to stand. MCC, you can look at our family, and can we just celebrate them again? We thank God for you. We celebrate you in Jesus' name. MCC strong. Amen. Love never fails. Amen, amen, amen. We celebrate, amen, you in Jesus' name. We thank you for your attention to the announcements, and we are indeed celebrating all that God is doing. We are praying for everybody, everyone. No one is left behind. We are praying collectively and individually for everyone because we know that prayer changes things. These list of individuals, we're praying for you, and beyond this list, we're praying for everyone. We're also praying for those that have experienced bereavement. Sister Treva Parker, who's part of our ministry, of course, and we're praying for her and her family in the loss of her grandmother, Mother Helen Ruth. We love you, Sister Trevor. The details of her service is also available for us. It's going to take place on Tuesday, April 23rd at Missouri Baptist Church in Suffolk, Virginia. If you need that information, feel free to call the church office. We are praying for the family of also Mother Ruby Hall and family. We love you, Mother Hall and your family, and the loss of your Uncle George Flowers Jr. To all those that's going through grief, know that we are praying for you in Jesus' name. Amen. Can we pray, amen, for everybody? Amen. Can we do that and clap our hands and thank God for strength? Strength is going in someone's direction. Healing is going in someone's direction in Jesus' name. It's time to give to our God. Amen. Amen. At this time, we're going to give in way of our tithe and our offering. Those that would desire to give with a check or envelope, if you want to place something in an envelope, you can lift your hands and our ushers will come and provide that to you. Our overseer, Sylvia Matthews, is coming and she's holding the bucket. Thank you, overseer. You can place your love gift in this bucket if you desire to do so. You can give. Also, we have various ways of giving. And we have various ways of giving. We can go to masterschild.org, Givelify, mail in your giving, or Zelle. Amen. As announced on last Sunday, we are having a current issue with our Cash App. Amen. It's going to be resolved. But right now, we ask if you would consider giving in another way. We appreciate each way. Every way that you give is appreciated. But today, amen, if you can give another way, our Cash App issue has not been resolved yet. But tell somebody it will be resolved in Jesus' name. And so we thank you for your patience as we get this resolved, but please give however you give. Please give with a cheerful heart, and we appreciate all that you do. We're grateful for what is to come, amen, here at the Master's Child Church. And because of your support and because of God's grace, amen, we're able to do all things, amen. And so we're asking, if you would like to give with a credit card, you can stand now if you desire to give. Overseer Vera is in the back to serve you. If you want to swipe your card or to scan your card, you can do that in Jesus' name, amen. How many of you are ready to give? Can you make some noise to the Lord? Thank you, Jesus. I have something to give. Amen. And we're glad about it. We're going to pray and we're going to give together, whether it be your tithe or your offering. Let's give unto the Lord. We thank you. Father, we thank you for another opportunity we have to give to you. You are good. And we thank you for allowing us to have something to give. God, I pray that you encourage everybody, no matter what situation they may be in financially. I pray that you will encourage everyone. There's someone that desires to give a certain amount, but they don't have what it is that they desire to give as it relates to something tangible, Father. But I thank you that you said, let everything that have breath pray. Praise the Lord. I pray that we'll give you praise, whether it be from our mouths, whether it be from our pockets, God. I pray, however we do it, that we'll do it with joy. We thank you for everyone that's sowing a seed. We thank you that you would allow us to reap what it is that you would desire us to reap. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen, amen, and amen. Let's continue to worship our Savior.
Before you, heaven,
heaven,
heaven.
want to wave your hand if you believe he's mighty.
What a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God.
You're the mighty God.
What a mighty God.
Come on, sing it again. What a
mighty God. What a mighty God.
You are the mighty
God. You're the mighty God. We serve. What a mighty God.
You're the mighty God.
You're the mighty God.
Come on, shout it out.
Our mighty God. I said, give our mighty God a great big hand. Has he been mighty in your heart, in your spirit, in your situation? He's a mighty God. And we give him all the glory and all the honor that is due to him. Somebody say hallelujah. Well, good morning in here. And praise the Lord to everyone who's in attendance. I greet you in that wonderful name, Jesus, the name that is above every name, that at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow and every tongue must confess that Jesus Christ, he is Lord. Anybody believe that on this morning? I do too. So good to see your faces in the place. Thank God for you and you who have pressed your way out on this morning to hear what the Spirit of the Lord will say unto the church. He that has an ear, let him hear what the Spirit is saying to the church. So glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. And this is where we are. We are in the house of the Lord to give God all the praise, all the honor that is due to him. I certainly want to honor everyone here again and thank God for my wife, First Lady Cheryl Robinson, and to... Yes, the matriarch of the Robinson family and the Master's Child Church co-founder, Irma Robinson Fitzgerald. And to the location pastor here, Pastor Sam, Lady Capria. And to all God's children, to all our first-time visitors, if you're here, thank you for being here. Really appreciate your presence with us here on this morning. Pray that your worship experience is going well for you. Amen. As we have gathered here to give God all the glory, all the praise, and all the honor, we owe him so much relative to what he has done and who he is. We worship him for who he is. We praise him for what he has done. And we thank God for that. For they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. Amen. And so we pray, amen, again, that your worship experience is going well with you. Thank God for all of our graduates today. We honor you. And we are really looking forward to what God is going to do through you. Some of you are going to get to work right away. Amen. We have assignments for you, and we are really excited about who God is sending here for the work of ministry as we are expanding and growing. Amen. The Bible talks about, amen, how the harvest is great. Amen. But the laborers are few. And we've been praying that God would send not members, but laborers. Amen. To work in, amen, the kingdom of God for his glory. Is that all right? Amen. And so we honor everyone here. I know the protocol has already been established. And so I'm going to get into the word of God. I'm going to share something with you. When the cameras go off, I want to talk to you about something real briefly. So we'll wait until the end of the service. Don't move. I want to tell you something that's on my heart about today. So let's make sure that we stay for that. And then we're going to honor our new members in the fellowship hall as well. So looking forward to that in Jesus' name. All right. Well, I want you to go to the book, The Gospel According to Mark. And I want you to consider chapter 8. Mark chapter 8. And we got Pastor Joe Hayden and Lady Z Hayden in the house. CC. Thank God for them. Amen. So good to see them in the house. They're doing such a fantastic job out in Bowie. Amen. And we want to commend them. In fact, we're going to be celebrating their one-year anniversary. Amen. And that's going to be on May 19th. May 19th at the Bowie location at 4 p.m. And we are putting some things together. Amen, for that celebration. And so as we get things together, we'll let you know what that's going to be like. Amen. But I'm excited about what God is doing in the area of Bowie. And I'm asking God to send them from the north, south, east, and west. Amen. To Bowie. Amen. Because Bowie got it going on. In Jesus' name. Is that all right? Amen. All right. So Mark 8. And I want you to consider the 34th verse. And I'm reading out of the Contemporary English Version. And I won't be before you long. But I do want to share with you what God has put in my heart today for your spiritual enrichment. The eighth chapter. 34th verse. Are you there? Jesus then told the crowd and the disciples to come closer. Come closer. And he said, if any of you want to be my followers, you must forget about yourself. Did you see that? You must forget about yourself. This is not about you. You must take up your cross and follow me. Lord, help me. That's what Jesus said. Peter didn't say that. Mark didn't say that. Paul, Jesus said to the crowd, come closer. Get closer to me. I want to tell you something. If you want to be my followers, you got to forget about yourself. Take up your cross and follow me. I want to talk from a topic entitled, Followers Beware. Followers Beware. Father, I thank you so much for this opportunity that you have given me to share the word of God. I thank you for the anointing, the fresh anointing that you're able to give one who relies on you. I need that. this morning. I need all that you can give me to convey what you have put in my heart for these your people who have come to hear from you. Not see me, but hear from you. Have your way in this place. In Jesus' name, amen. And before I start, I want to thank Pastor Sam and Pastor Andre for speaking on Sunday in my stead. I do a wonderful job. I had a speaking engagement in Louisiana on last Sunday. God moved mightily, but it's no place like home. I'm so glad to be home in Jesus' name. This is Jesus talking. Of course, we want to make sure that we align our theology this month with what God has given us by way of a theme, where he leads, we will follow. And this is just another text that amplifies the significance of the theme that we are focusing in on for this month. This is Jesus talking. I'm very intrigued when Jesus talks, because now there's no dispute about whether it's something that we should see as theologically sound or accurate, because when Jesus opens up his mouth to speak, then we know that he can't lie. He cannot lie. There's no inaccuracy connected to his commentary. Everything that he speaks, everything that he says, is the truth, because he's a man that cannot lie, son of man, that would never have to repent, because he said something to us that was not true. And the one thing he did mention to us, that you will know the truth, and the truth will make you free. He can't make you believe it. He only can tell you. And we got a lot of individuals who hear Jesus' words but don't believe. But I want you to know that he made a believe out of me, because absolutely everything that he has ever uttered, everything that he has ever declared, once I've applied it to my life, it has manifest. Now, you know, it may take a minute. I may have to wait on him. Amen. But whatever God has spoken, it will come to pass. That's why I like the relationship between the disciples and Jesus. Jesus picked these individuals. He just, you know, say, follow me. They dropped everything. They just dropped everything and just followed him, you know. And I don't, and hear me good before I let you go. You know, you can't be a follower of Christ if you're not willing to drop some stuff. Yeah, some stuff you got to drop, you know, some stuff that you may be holding on to that may be preventing you from reaching your maximum potential as a follower in Jesus Christ. Hey, they didn't apologize, drop it. They didn't say sorry. It's been 10 years. Go ahead and drop it. Just, you know, you've been holding a grudge because somebody betrayed you. They're not losing no sleep. They probably in Jamaica right now getting some sun. You know, can I give you some advice? Go ahead and just drop it. Just drop it. And I know it hurt, but you got to drop it. If you're going to be a follower of Jesus Christ, there are some things that you have to drop. The problem is, you know where you dropped them. And you can always go pick it up. That will prolong your vexation. And when I say you know where you dropped, you know where you dropped those things. I'm not talking about physically dropping something, but I'm talking about from a mental standpoint, a spiritual standpoint. You know how to pick those things back up when it comes to you feeling like that, you know, you still have something to prove, that you feel like there's some vengeance that needs to be executed towards amongst those who did you harm. But vengeance is not yours. The Bible said it is the Lord. And this is the thing that really intrigued me about the conversation that Jesus would have with his disciples every now and again. And he begins to tell his disciples, he said, now I'm going to tell you what's going to happen to me. He says, something's going to happen to me. He says that the nation leaders and the chief priests and the teachers of the law, the Mosaic law, they're going to cause me to suffer terribly. They're going to cause me to suffer terribly. But what's going to happen, they're going to reject me. They're going to kill me. But on the third day, I'm going to rise to life. You see. Now, this is the thing that really blessed me, that nothing happened to Jesus that he didn't know was going to happen in advance. So can you imagine that everything that has happened to you, Jesus knew it was going to happen before. I wish I had Indian hair this morning. Before it happened, and then you're trying to figure out why God has taken you through so much. I want you to know he takes you through what he takes you through so you can be spiritually fit to handle what has not happened right now that he know is coming. And sometimes you'll feel like you can't take something that you're taking. You can't get through something that you're getting through. You're saying, I can't make it, but you're making it at the same time because God has given you what he knew in advance that you would need to handle what he knew would happen at some point in your life. Because he began to tell the disciples, this is what's going to happen to me. Before it happens, I'm going to let you know it's going to happen. Can I say something to you before I let you go? Some things are going to happen. Now, I don't know what's going to happen. I don't know if it's going to be A, B, C, X, Y, Z, but something is going to happen. That's why you are sitting in these seats right now, because God is, he's elevating your strength. He's elevating your trust. He's elevating your confidence in him. And so when these things come, you can look back and say, God, I thank you for preparing me for the things that I didn't know what were going to take place, but you knew and you prepared me for it. And some of you have survived some of the most, difficult tests and trials in your life. And I'm not telling you it's easy. I'm not telling you that you're over it. I'm not telling you that you're good, but you're good enough to be in the house of a God. I wish I had somebody here who knows absolutely everything and can be everything to you. I wish I had four people who know that God didn't answer all my prayers the way that I thought he was going to answer, but he knew what was going to happen, and he strengthened me. He strengthened me and told me to endure hardness like a good soldier. I see you, Miosha. See, that's encouragement to me. That's encouragement to me because I want the devil to know, and I ain't going to be before you long, that nothing that happens in my life, nothing, not one thing that has ever happened in my life, I want you to know God, that God wasn't aware of it. He knew it was coming. And now I want you to know that if the enemy was smart, he would not allow me to go through anything. But now that I've gone through the things that I've gone through, now I can clearly say that can't nobody do me like Jesus. Because the thing that got me in here, you got to hear this. Not only did he say he was going to be betrayed, he's going to be killed, he's going to be rejected, but he said that, don't let the story end right there. He said, but I'm going to get back up again. I don't have nobody here. See, don't fall asleep on that part. He did say he's going to be rejected, he's going to be killed. But he said, after they've done everything they've done to me, I want to talk to the get back up again people. You're not saying that you've had an easy life. You didn't say that everything was peachy cream. But after everything you've been through, God gave you the power to get back. Hallelujah. Can you tell somebody next to you, you can get back up again. You can. I'm almost finished. Yeah, I was depressed, but I got back up. Yeah, I was racking in pain, but I got back up. I felt defeated, but I got back up. Foot almost slipped. Amen, but I got back. Do I have somebody in here who can thank the Lord that when the enemy started having a party and thought your life was over, you said, surprise, I'm back. Not only did he come back, but he came back with all power. Lord, help me. I feel the Holy Ghost in this place. Somebody say hallelujah. You may. So he says, this is the thing. This, glory. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Yeah. He says, yeah. Lord, help me. Don't mind me. I just had a flashback. I mean, the enemy hit me with a big shot, and I thought I was not going to bounce back from it. But I want you to know that weeping may endure for a night, but joy, I don't have five people. It will come, to come in the morning. Lord, help me here. Somebody say hallelujah. Jesus sat down and he said, the Bible says that he explained clearly everything that he had mentioned to them. He had made clear everything that he had said. And then I want you to hear this ending here. If you miss this, you're going to miss the whole message. Peter took Jesus aside, pulled him from the crowd, pulled him from the pulpit, pulled him from the podium, said, let me talk to you. Jesus pulled him over in a corner and said, Jesus, stop talking like that. He said, stop talking like that. Indian head, you got to hear me. The follower is telling the leader. Yeah, the Peter, cutting off ears, Peter, cussing people out, Peter. Told Jesus, I need to see you in my office. And then Peter said, Jesus, stop talking like that. Can I say something to you? If you don't get this, you're gonna miss the whole message. Some people will not like what you say. But I'm going to tell you, Indian head, straight up, you got to say it. You got to say it anyway. That's what I'm saying. As a pastor, I thank God for your blessings because God uses you to bless me, and I thank God for that. You can bless me, but you can't buy me. I'd rather for you to keep your seed than to try to buy me. Now I got to go in your corner. Every time I talk about sin and every time I talk about unrighteousness or every time the word hits your toes, I got to meet with you and I have to hear you say, you shouldn't have said, you got to stop talking. You can talk about blessings. You can talk about favor. You can talk about my next level. You can talk about all that. But when you start talking about my sin and my proclivity and you start talking about my shortcomings and my failures, we got to have a meeting. Stop talking like that. When you let people control your mouth like that, I'm telling you, that's an unhealthy connection that you have with people because people want to regulate what you say because they want to hear what they want to hear and not what they need to hear. And I want to say this to everybody in here. Sometimes you need to be rebuked. You need to be. Oh, I wish I had some. I don't have real people here. You need to be told that you got to grow up. You need to tell. You need somebody to tell you stop acting immature. You need somebody to tell you that you missed the mark. You need somebody to tell you that you're not living right. You need somebody to tell you that you got to give up some things so you can walk in the holiness of God.
And it's the very thing that you don't want to hear are the things that cause you to mature and grow up. Because you'll start looking at everybody else. And you're not looking at you. Because every time you hear something that challenges you, don't say that. Don't talk about me like that. And the problem with this is that they know they're wrong. But they don't like hearing that they're wrong because of arrogancy. So it's an issue that they have in the area of pride that nobody can help them see themselves. So don't talk like that. Rev, I'll come to church, but as soon as you start talking about my issues, my problems, I don't want to hear it. Well, how can they hear without a preacher? How can he preach unless he be sent? Beautiful are the feet of those who preach the gospel. And that's why Paul told Timothy, preach it in season, out of season, when they want to hear it, and when they don't want to hear it, because faith cometh by hearing. Yeah, hearing by. Shut up, Jesus. Shut up. Don't want to hear nothing you got to say. You know what Jesus said? I'm almost finished. Jesus said, Peter, for real? You pulled me from the crowd. You pulled me from my assignment. Here I am trying to get people saved. I'm trying to establish followers of Jesus Christ. And you pull me in your office for something like that? Jesus turned and saw the disciples. He said, listen. He said, come here, Peter. Come right here. I want you to come right here. Stand right here. He said, Peter, stand right here. He didn't call Peter. He didn't say Peter. He said, Satan. Get behind me. I wish I had some Bible readers in it. Because he said, Peter, this ain't even about you. It's a spirit that's on you that I got to rebuke. Because sometimes we rebuke people, but we don't rebuke demons. It's a demon behind rebellion. It's a demon behind the disinterest of the revelations of God. There's a spirit that rejects correction. Get behind me. In other words, I'm the leader. You're the follower. He said because you're thinking like everyone else, but you're not thinking like God. Yeah. You're thinking like everybody else, but you're not thinking like God. So that you have to remember that when people begin to speak in a way that's antithetical to the revelations of God, you have to say, who are you talking to? Who are you speaking to raise such a concern about what Jesus is saying when everything that Jesus says we need to hear? But he said, you're not thinking like God, you're thinking like people. The greatest deliverance that I've ever experienced in my life is deliverance from people. I don't have two people on that part. Deliverance from, I don't care if you don't like me. I don't care if you don't support me. You don't have to listen to me. You don't have to indulge me. But I know one thing. I've come in this house not so you can give me your attention, but I came here to please God. That's it. Listen, when I looked in the mirror, I did not have you in mind when it came to what I put on. So if you don't like it, stop looking. If you don't like what I'm saying, you don't have to listen. But what God put in my mouth, put in my heart, I'm sharing it because I'm trying to please God. You can't please people. If you please them today, it's going to be something else tomorrow. If you please them today, it's going to be something else Thursday. You can't please everybody. Your aim is just to please God. He said, I want you to
get behind me because you're not thinking like God. You're thinking like everybody else. And you can't let people become your God. You have to know there's only one God. One faith. That's apostolic right there. One baptism. Somebody say hallelujah. Jesus said, I want crowd, come here. The disciples, come here. I want you to come closer to me. Come closer. People who don't understand how the revelation of God comes in to correct us and to guide us and direct us, it's an issue as to how divided they are from a God that they need to get closer to. And this is what I'm going to challenge you today. I'm going to give you 3 points. I want to challenge you to get closer and closer and closer to God. That means you have to tune out the theology, the theory, the perspective of people, and let the revelation of God be the primary guide for your life. He said, I want you to come closer. He said, come closer, come closer. He said, listen to me, listen to me, listen to me. Don't listen to Peter. Don't listen to Mark. Don't listen to James. Listen to me. If any one of you want to be my followers, you got to forget about yourself. Oh, I wish I had somebody here. Because it's not about you. It's not about how you feel all the time. It's not about your mindset, especially when it comes to honoring God and making him the priority. If you want, you don't have to follow me, but if you want to follow me, forget about yourself. Peter tried to make that moment about him. But that moment was not about Peter. It was about Jesus giving people an opportunity to understand his purpose. I came here to die, but I'm going to get up again. I'm going to go through something, but I'm going to get up again. Don't let people tell you that living for God means you're not going to go through nothing, that you're not going to experience anything. That's just not true. All of us are going to go through something, but if we suffer with him, we'll reign. Open your mouth and say, followers, beware. Beware of the first point. Beware of the first point, my first point, self-centeredness. Beware when you make everything about you. Everything must involve everything you want to do, everything that you feel we need to do, everything that we say. We got to say it the way you want us to say it. We got to do it the way that you want us to do it. And then after we do everything you want us to do, then how do we please God and you? He said, if you're going to follow me, forget about yourself. And that don't mean you are insignificant. That means you know the priority is just not you. It's God. You see? Look, this is what bothers me. Can y'all help me? This is what bothers me. When a person gets to the place that they are self-sufficient, they forgot the people who helped them when they were not self-sufficient. Oh, I don't have two people. Yeah, I'm talking about when you couldn't feed yourself, when you couldn't put Pampers on yourself. I know you can afford a roof over your head now, but somebody had to pay your mortgage and your rent. When I'm talking about when the mail wasn't coming in your name. When you couldn't put shoes, you can't get to a point that you forget everybody who helped you to get to this point, and you never look back and say, God, I thank you for the people who helped me to get to where I am. No, you don't do that, because God has a way of taking you back to a situation that you can remember. If it had not been for him using people to help you get your mind right and get your life right, where you would be. Followers, beware of point number one. What to say? Self what? Self-centeredness. That everything has to be about you. You're not concerned about nobody else but you. Matter of fact, just meet me halfway. You know, I had a person say, Bishop, you never speak to me. That's what they told me. If it's a lie, I'm telling you. He said, you never speak to me. I said, well, I'm sorry. I said, but sometimes if you want somebody to speak to you, sometimes you may want to speak to that person. Because I never deliberately will walk past somebody and not speak to them. But if you're so concerned about me not speaking to you, that's a two-way street. Because I never questioned why you didn't speak to me, but some reason you'll question why I didn't speak to you. Matter of fact, if you want some, listen, if you want to be complimented, won't you compliment, because see, you'll reap what you sow. You see, I don't know why I'm telling you my experiences. I held the door for a young lady. I was coming out of the gym, held the door. She just walked in, just like I had to hold it. I wish I had five people. Yeah, I'm broke down. I'm in doing crunches and working out. All my arm through here, just numb. I just all through here. I ain't got nothing, but I'm using the last bit of strength to hold the door. This young girl, she just rushed through and went to the gym. I'm holding it. I'm waiting for her to say, at least thank you. But that moment wasn't about me holding the door. That moment was about the fact that she didn't have to open the door, walk right in, and start working out. But what happened, watch this, her mother came behind her. And this is what her mother said. Her mother said, I want to thank you for holding the door for me and my daughter. You know what she said? I didn't raise her like that. She said she's having a moment. She explained to me that the reason why she didn't say thank you is because they had some type of issue on the way to the gym. You see what I'm saying? And it made sense at that point because all of us have moments. All of us have, you know, look up and down. But so the thing is, when the mother explained it to me, I gave her grace. Because watch this. God, I wish I had time. What time is it? Oh, I don't have time to teach this. Because at least I know that wasn't how she was raised. And when you are being raised by the power of God and the standards of God's word, there's certain things that you ought to honor when it comes to not talking about things, but practicing the things that you have been taught. You see? So don't speak in tongues in church and don't say hi. How you doing? You doing all right in English? Because I can't understand your tongue, but I can understand your English. Because some people say that speaking in tongue is the evidence of the Holy Spirit. Okay. I that can be debated. Because I know a whole lot of people who speak in tongues who just nasty. Just nasty. You know what I'm saying? I'm not impressed with your tongue. I'm impressed with your character and how you treat people you think you don't need. Because I know a whole lot of people who don't speak in tongues, they're going to heaven. I'm going to deal with that on Pentecost. Because Jesus said, when the Holy Ghost comes, you shall have not tongues, but power. That's what Jesus said. That's what Jesus said. Our forefathers have said something else, especially depends on who what organization or reformation you grew up under. But when you get older, you search the scriptures for yourself. So I'd rather for you just speak English. You don't speak something, but just be nice, be kind. I mean, I'm talking about the fruit of the Spirit. Point number two, followers, beware of self-preservation. Self-preservation. I'm not talking about healthy self-preservation. I'm talking about extreme self-preservation. That you reserve yourself from being involved in certain things because you're trying to preserve your arrogant attitude. Not me. Oh, you're trying to reserve a certain part of who you are because you don't want to yield all of who you are to the will of God. So I'll sit back. You don't want to engage in the things that God is calling you to because you feel like it's too risky. I may get hurt. Well, listen, you can get hurt. Let me tell you, hurt show up. In other words, I want you to know that I understand what church hurt is all about, and it's unfortunate it happens. But I've been hurt on my job, and I didn't quit.
I mean nasty managers and supervisors. Next morning, I'm punching in. How can I help you? Welcome to Chuck E. Cheese. What pizza do you want? Church is the only place. I wish I had somebody here. That if you get hurt, they said, there's no hurt that anybody can execute upon you that God cannot heal. Because sometimes people are hurt you because they insecure about what they see on your life. But if God be for you, no one can be. So I don't want to work in ministry. Yes, you don't let nobody stop you from working where God has put you. And don't be concerned about the antics of the people. He said, if you want to be followers of me, forget about yourself. He said, in other words, he said, if you save your life, if you preserve your life, can I just teach it the way I feel it? If you save your life, you're going to lose it. You're going to lose it. You're going to destroy it. If you save it the way, because matter of fact, you can't save your life. The only person who can save your life is the one who went to Calvary and died for your life. He said, but if you give your life up, if you trust me and give your life up for me and the good news, he says, I'll save you. He said, what's the use gaining the whole world and losing your soul? Hey, losing my soul over your nasty look, your nasty disposition. You don't have to like me, but I'm glad that God loves me. You ain't gonna push me out of where God put me in, because if he put me in it, you can't take me out of it. So move over. Give me my fan and give me my program, because I got a seat in the kingdom of God. So don't be fearful. And I'm not telling you people ought to treat you anyway. And God knows when you come here, I hope you feel the love of God. But there's some people who just don't get it. Just don't get it. And however God calls you to deal with that, you got to deal with that. Because sometimes people don't miss you until you're gone. Because God's going to put you in a place where you're going to be appreciated, valued, used. I wish I had somebody. And loved, last point I got for you, according to the love that God wants you to experience. Love deprivation is a horrible thing, especially when you give love, but you don't get love. You see, because love is synonymous with who? God. God is. God just doesn't love. He is. It's love. Last point, we gone. Followers, beware of what? Self-sabotage. That's when you undermine your own eternal success. He said, if you be ashamed of me, don't let these people mess you up. If you be ashamed of me in front of these faithless, unfaithful sinners, he said, when I get to glory and I get before my Father and the holy angels, I'm going to be ashamed of you. I want to talk to any here, because I believe I got some people who are not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ. For it is the power unto God, unto salvation, unto the Jews, unto the Greeks. I want you to know that I'm not sure. I'll tell it everywhere I go that Jesus Christ, he is Lord. He's Savior. I like to tell Master Child every now and again, I don't let nobody make me feel ashamed about my expression or my reaction to the things of God. When my family and I are out or whoever is with us when we're out, I don't hesitate to bless my food. I don't care if an atheist around or I don't care who's around. I'm going to open up my mouth and say, God, I thank you for the food that's on my table. I don't know who cooked this chicken. I don't know what they did with it. But I'm going to bless this food right now, because no hurt, no harm, no danger is going to come upon us. And I pray when I pay for the food that my card goes through. Because you said you would supply all of my needs according to. So what he says, when you self-sabotage, is when you start giving yourself the credit. When you start giving yourself the glory. When you start giving yourself the honor. I didn't know. I need five people here who know, if it had not been for God, who was on my side. I made a wreck of my life. I messed my whole life up. But the Bible says that if any man be in Christ, he's a new creature. All things are passed away. Behold, all things are new. I don't know about you, Indian head, my time is up, but I just want to thank him real quick. For when I didn't know what to do with my life, he stepped into my life. And he said, listen, the devil comes to steal, kill, and destroy, but I've come that you may have life and life more abundantly. I wish I had somebody in here who knows. Since Jesus has been in your life has gone to, another level. And this is not about your haters messing you up. This is not about your doubters. It's making sure that you don't do anything that will sabotage what God has next in your life. So whenever God is ready to take you to another level, take you to another dimension, followers do what? Beware. Stay out of the way. Because watch this. Get this in your mind. If you're not in God's will, you are in his way. Look at your neighbor and say, pray that I stay out of God's way. Clap your hands if you understood the message. Father, I thank you for every individual that's here today. I thank you. Because we are followers of you. We dare not give ourselves glory and honor. We dare not dictate to you what you need to say, how you need to conduct yourself, things that you need to orchestrate in our lives. God, we submit all of who we are to your will. If you need somebody, if you really need somebody, send us. We'll go. If you need somebody to declare your word, send us. We'll go. If you need somebody to lay hands on the sick, send us. We'll go. Lord knows if you need some worshipers. Yeah, we'll take that too. We'll worship you in the beauty of holiness. Help us to be conscious of ourselves. We don't want to worry about nobody else in this moment but ourselves, to make sure we don't make everything about us, that we will pick up our crosses and follow you. The cross is the death by crucifixion, that we will crucify our flesh, crucify our negative attitudes, crucify our selfishness, crucify our arrogance, so we can get out of your way and let your glory shine in our lives. God, help us to pick up our cross daily and every day, that we see ourselves becoming more important than you, that we crucify it, we crucify it. We nail it to the cross, understanding that it's our cross that we must bear because you bore yours. And we thank you for how you went to Calvary, died for our sins, and now we have the right to the tree of life. No more I, but it's you, to the glory of God. In Jesus' name, amen. Clap your hands and give God glory. Somebody here today, I don't know where you are in life. I don't know what's happening. But God knew it was going to happen before it happened, and he orchestrated this moment. He created this moment to give you an opportunity to come to this altar, to give your life to Christ, or to be a part of this local church. You know, people, you know, it's amazing. You know, when people feel like that they ought to be the ones who provide you with solutions and resolutions that's outside of the will of God for your life. What I'm telling you today This is a decision that you have to make for yourself. Because when it's all over, you don't stand before the judgment seat of God as a couple. You don't stand there as a group, but you stand there by yourself. And you got to give an account of the deeds that's been done in your body. And if I was you, I'll let go of that self-preservation. Say, God, I give you all. I give myself away for your glory. And if you're here, I want you to come. If you need to be saved, you need to rededicate your life to Christ, I want you to come. Come on, my brother. Jesus Christ. That's my brother right there. That's my brother right there. You did, yeah. Come on, clap your hands for my brother. Anybody else? Anybody else? Want to be a part of this ministry? You want to yoke up with the kingdom of God? I want you to come. Want to be a part of Master Child? I want you to come. You want to rededicate your life and say, you know what? It's been about me long enough. I got to do something. I got to do something. I gotta get back to it. Come on, man. Come on. Come on. Come on. Yes, sir.
Jesus Christ.
Clap your hands, Master Child. Now, I want to say this to you. I thank God for these two souls that have come to the altar. Somebody may say, I need a fresh start. I just need a fresh start. I need a reset. I need to get back to a good place. I heard a message today, and I got to beware of the fact that it's not about me. It's not about nobody else. It's how God is leading me. This ain't got nothing to do with nobody else. This is how God is leading me, and I feel this in my spirit. I want to give you an opportunity to come. Just come. Just come and trust God. You can't let nobody pull you into the office and stop talking like that. Stop thinking like that. Stop allowing yourself to be guided in a way that God wants you to go. You got 30 seconds. Come on. Come on. Who is it? Come on. Come on. Don't let nobody talk you out of your next, because your next is already scheduled in God. All you have to do is, he said, if you take one step, he said, I'll take two. Is it anybody else? You got 15 seconds. I gotta go. Anybody else? Anybody else? Anybody else? 10 seconds. Come on. Come on. Come on. Clap your hands and give God glory. My brother, welcome. Welcome. Everyone. Yeah. Say it again, say it again. Jesus. Just tell God, I give myself away, my heart, my mind. Use me the way that you want to use me. Send me where you want me to go. My aim is to please you. No more I, but it's the Christ that's in me. If you mean that, If you're going to be committed to that, give God glory by a hand clap of praise. You may be seated. Did you get anything out of this teaching today? Wonderful, wonderful. All right. Not yet. I'm going to have you cut it off in a minute. Okay. All my men, I want you to know we're going to be mapping out what our men's month in June is going to be about. And I want every man to be prepared to register Bowie, Indian Head, Capitol Heights, every man, and every man that you can bring. We want to map out that month. We're going to let you know what that's all about. I'll be speaking. The location pastors are going to be speaking. We're going to be dealing with mental health, spiritual health, physical health. We're going to tackle the whole issue man to man. Yeah, you can't be no boy on this one. You got to be a man on this one. We're going to talk it out. We're going to talk it out. We're going to really have a good huddle. And at the end of the day, I believe at the end of the month, we're going to be better for what God wants us to do as men in our homes and in our communities, and especially in the church. Amen. The Master Child men are ready to go to a whole different level in God. I believe that. We're going to have professionals come in and talk to us, and special guests. We're going to have a wonderful time. We may do a 5K walk. Get your mind right. Get all your minds right. That's what Brown said. Get your minds right. Is that right? Amen. We're going to have a wonderful time. And then Family Month is in July. And we're going to just talk about family dynamics the whole month. And then we're going to have professionals come in to speak about the roles that we play within the family, fathers, mothers, and how that dynamic is changing. And it's looking kind of different outside of the will of God. But we're going to stay in the book. We're going to mimic the book in Jesus' name. Is that all right? Amen. All right. So may God's peace be with you until we meet again. May God keep you, is my prayer. May you live in the days that you prayed for. And you know who we are. MCC Strong. Why? Because we can do all things through Christ who strengthens us. God bless you. Amen. Godspeed. You can cut it off.
On behalf of Bishop Melvin Robinson Jr. and First Lady Cheryl Robinson, thank you for attending the Master's Child Church Cyber Sanctuary. We enjoyed worshiping with you. If this teaching has been a blessing to you, we encourage you to sow a seed with any of these giving options. Givelify, search Master's Child Church, specify your amount, and done. The Cash App, $Master's Child. Our church website, www.masterschild.org. Or use our mailing address, P.O. Box 7810, Upper Marlboro, Maryland, 20792. And join us this week for our weekly services. 6 a.m. prayer, Monday through Friday, our conference call. Noonday prayer, on Tuesdays, via our conference call. Real Word Wednesday, 7:30 p.m., Facebook Live. Walking in Newness, radio broadcast, 10 a.m., Facebook Live. And Sunday Morning Manna, 11 a.m., Facebook Live. As a reminder, if you have any questions or need prayer during the week, please contact the church office at 301-200-1615. Thank you for joining the Master's Child Church. One church, three locations.